Good morning to one and all present over here. It's my gratitude and I feel honored to be the part of this program. And my theme is National Voters Awareness. As we all are well aware that we are the citizen of democratic country. And we must recognize and realize it that this democracy we got after a long struggle by our freedom fighter. And India at present is the world's largest democracy. And think for a while that if India is a democratic country, then what kind of circumstances compelling the government, a conceptual term government, to organize such kind of programs to mobilize the voters or to strengthen the voters for active political participation. We all are well aware that in India we are democratic, we are having the part and parcel of democracy, and it is the country that empower the people. And who empower the people? That is the constitution, the law. India, we are having the written constitutions, and written constitution clearly culminate and declare that the ultimate source of authority resides in the hand of people. And this ultimate source of authority must be recognized and realized by the people. And this source of authority is vote. And it is mandatory, and it is the sole responsibility and the moral duties of all the citizens of India that we must actively, freely and fairly participate in the lawmaking process of the country. As we all are well aware that India is a modern, democratic, socialist, sovereign, democratic republic state, and the true epitome or the base is voting. What we call today is government is active or government is not active, what government is doing and how government should perform, the sole authority is derived from the hand of the people of India. And to whom we vote, why we vote, when we vote and how to vote is totally from the government. As government is the superstructure and voters are the base. These are the two non-living entity, only the conceptual term. One is vote and another is government. And the participations of the people make the both the concept functional and important. We peoples must be extra aware and familiar that in a democratic world, the participation of people is most important. Most of the time, what we observe that during the election or on the day of election, what we people observe that people consider the day of election as another holiday. Why? Because of the lack of awareness. And it is the responsibility of the educated youth to spread the value or the importance of vote. Every vote counts. Recently, just अभी पहले लेक्चर में डॉक्टर योगेश जी ने बड़ा ब्रीफ करके बताया कि कैसे जो है गवर्नमेंट डिफरेंट किस्म के थीम लेकर के लोगों तक अवेयरनेस स्प्रेड करने की कोशिश कर रही है. इफ द एफर्ट्स मेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट कांट रीच टू द पब्लिक, देन द डेमोक्रेसी कांट बी अचीव्ड. इफ वी बिलीव इन द टर्म द डेमोक्रेसी इज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द पीपल, देन पीपल मस्ट रियलाइज दैट द पार्टिसिपेशन इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. In the 2019 elections of Lok Sabha, peoples very actively participated in the electoral practices. In these electoral practices, the percentage, the ratio is going just to be the 67%. And 67%, 100% से कितना down है, फिर भी हमें लगता है कि इतनी अगर above 50% election participation है, तो वो ठीक है. अगर लोग अपने वोट को इंटरेस्टिंगली पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करेंगे तो जस्ट थिंक ओवर कि जितने लोग वोट कास्ट करेंगे उनके उनके विल उनके इंटरेस्ट के अकॉर्डिंगली रिप्रेजेंटेटिव आ जाएगा सामने. देन हाउ विल वी क्लेम दिस इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबल गवर्नमेंट. if we believe that in India we are having the responsible government, then the most important characteristics within the responsible government is the responsibility must be in the head of the voters. Voters must be extra active, voters must be extra responsible. Only the responsive characters of the voter make the political system responsive or cohesive in character. We all are well aware that voting is the tool of election. Elections is the important instrument within the democracy. And when we vote in India, we are having the universal adult franchise system. This is the true example of equality in India, where every citizen, initially it was the age of 21, but at present we are having the 18 years of age, where all the people of India can cast one vote only, the true epitome of equality. And this equality can be used by the people without any kind of differences and discrimination. And the Constitution of India, starting with the word we, include us, it is totally inclusive in character, and providing the equal, or what we can say, the vibrant kind of platform to all the citizens of India to choose their representatives and choose the representative without any kind of differences and discrimination, and choose the representative that can lead the nation. Because by casting our vote, we make a very common individual the very special and VIP. Just think over, while casting your vote, while using your right to vote, that is the political right, one thing must be in our mind, that we are choosing our leader, and it is the sole responsibility of that particular individual to lead the people, to serve the people, to govern the people, to work for the upliftment and betterment of the country. We all are well aware that in India we are having the term, universal adult franchise or suffrage, where although in the political structure of India we are having the mixed political culture, we are not having the participant political culture, we are having the mixed political culture, where most of the time we people cast our vote on parochialism. We cast our vote on the basis of our region, our different kind of ethnic issues and identity. But think about it, that the choice is the will of the voter, compelling the political system of the country from one party dominant system to the multiple party system at this point of time. And at present, we are having more than 100 registered political parties representing the nook and corners of India, and trying to serve the feelings, the ideas, the thought, the expectations of the people. And at this point of time, it was the first time general elections of India, when India is having the one party dominant system. And in the 21st century, we all are witnessing and observing that no single party is in a position to form the government, national or the local or state level. Each and every kind of feeling or interest of the peoples or the voters compelling the different political parties to form the government, either through coalition or through the formation of alliances. And these are the feelings and the active political participations of the voters of India compelling the government to go for alliance. And presently we are having the two leading alliance, these are UPA and NDA. And as far as the term parochial political culture in India, very few people are also having the concept, the intellect, the wisdom of what we can say the participatory kind of culture. But most probably we people belong to the parochial or the subject political culture. For the voters, the participation is important. Try to participate for your development. Try to participate for your upliftment. Because I already quoted that you are the base and political system is the superstructure. Agar aapko lagta hai ki political system ke andar ye cheeze theek ho rahi hai, to it means ye cheeze aapne apne haathon se political system ko di. Agar aap chahte ho ki political system ke andar ye cheeze dalne ki zarurat hai, to it can only be possible by the active participation of the voters. आप लोगों की सोच आपके वोट के जरिए पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम के अंदर पहुंचती है, तो यू मस्ट एक्टिवली and voluntarily participate for the development of the nation. The important terms within the political system, for example, the national interest, the national integration, the national unity, the foreign policy, the national power, these all are conceptual terms. Basically, the national interest is the sum total interest of the voters of India. It means voters value, your vote value, your participation value. What kind of interest, what kind of vibrant approach, what kind of valuable ideas you peoples are having, all can be transferred only and only by casting vote to the political system. आप जिस किस्म का पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम चाहते हो, आपकी जिस किस्म की पॉलिसी है, वही पॉलिसी आप अपने लीडर्स को थ्रू वोट बना करके भेजते हो और नेशनल और इंटरनेशनल लेवल में आपकी कंट्री की फॉरेन पॉलिसी रिप्रेजेंट, सर्व और स्ट्रेंथन होती है. सो द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एजेंडा ऑफ द डे इज एक्टिव सिंसियर एंड फेयर पॉलिटिकल पार्टिसिपेशन, दैट इज द मोबिलाइजेशन ऑफ वोटर्स. Voters even sometimes became reluctant to vote during the process of election. That is not suitable in a democratic country. Democracy ke andar sabse important cheez hai ki voters jo hai wo bilkul actively, interestingly ja karke kisi bhi particular polling station mein apna vote cast kare. Agar unko political education hai to the rest of the youth ko adjoining areas ki population ko politically educate kare. उनके वोट की वैल्यू उन तक पहुंचाई जाए. वोट आप अपने इंटरेस्ट के अकॉर्डिंगली, अपने इंटेंशन के अकॉर्डिंगली कास्ट करें. डोंट ट्राई टू कास्ट योर वोट फॉर पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज और एनी काइंड ऑफ आइडियोलॉजी. जस्ट वोट फॉर डेवलपमेंट, जस्ट वोट फॉर बेटरमेंट, जस्ट वोट फॉर चेंज. जिस भी इंटेंशन और पर्पज से आप वोट कास्ट करोगे, आपको वही डेवलपमेंट मिलेगी. आप सबको ये पता है कि वोट जब हम कहते हैं कि एक वोट का कोई मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम व्हेन पीपल स्टार्ट अलाइनिंग टूवर्ड्स द पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम, तो वो इलेक्शन डे को जो है वो हॉलीडे शिफ्ट कर देते. लेकिन आपके वोट ना कास्ट करने से कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस बैड होने का भी इक्वल चांसेस रहता है. इसलिए आप वोट कास्ट करोगे. और अगेन आप देखें, इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया इज गिविंग इक्वल काइंड ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड चांसेस फॉर द डेवलपमेंट. और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि अगर आपको किसी भी आइडियोलॉजी को लेकर के आप एग्री नहीं है, तो यू आर नॉट सपोज टू नॉट टेक पार्टिसिपेट इन द पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेसेस. इवन देन यू हैव टू पार्टिसिपेट एंड गो फॉर नोटा, बिकॉज नोटा इज आल्सो अ वाइब्रेंट काइंड ऑफ अप्रोच टू शो द एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ पीपल्स विद इन द कंट्री. द वोट, यू ऑल आर वेल अवेयर अबाउट दैट vote is not only our right, it is our responsibility, it is our moral duty, it is our moral duty to choose, to elect our representative, our political leaders that can lead us, that can work for us, that can be or may be responsible to us, because voting is pride for a responsible citizen. India being the largest democratic countries of the world with written constitutions, empowering the people, organizing each and every kind of possible awareness programs to the people, for the people, and upliftment and betterment of the people by analyzing it, that indirectly peoples make the decision. What we can quote here, that government is making the decision. How government is capable to make the decision? By our vote. हमारा वोट गवर्नमेंट को इस काबिल बनाता है कि वो डिसीजन बना करके पॉलिसी फॉर्मेशन में, एग्जीक्यूशन में हमारे पास आता है. अगर हमें वो डिसीजन ठीक नहीं लगते, तो इसका मतलब कि हमने अपने वोट का प्रॉपर इस्तेमाल नहीं किया है. ईच एंड एवरी सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया मस्ट यूज दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट वोटिंग राइट एज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, एज द मॉरल ड्यूटी. एंड विद इन द डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री दिस इज ए बिग प्लेटफॉर्म to share his or her views without any kind of suppression or restrictions. It is voting right is an important way or agenda of change. Only when we go for change, this is the legitimate way to work for the change. Then at last, while concluding my speech, यहाँ पे बहुत सारे students बैठे हुए हैं. बहुत सारे आप में से जो है वो वोटिंग राइट तक पहुंच भी गए होंगे 18 इयर्स तक वो भी गए होंगे, तो माय सबमिशन टू ऑल ऑफ यू कि बीइंग द रिस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन ऑफ द कंट्री, आप सबने जो है वो एक्टिवली पॉलिटिकल राइट का इस्तेमाल करना है। अगेन आप देखिए, अगर आपको लगता है कि राइट टू इक्वालिटी में कहीं प्रॉब्लम आ रही है तो कंसीडर इट कि दिस इज राइट, ऑल्दो इट इज अ पॉलिटिकल राइट बट दिस इज ऑल्सो ए राइट, और ये राइट है जो आपको आप तक पहुंचाया जाता है और आपको कहा जाता है कि थ्रू दिस राइट यू आर द पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट आर द डिसीजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस। और इंडिया वो कंट्री है कि जिसने फर्स्ट इलेक्शन से ही यूनिवर्सल अडल्ट फ्रेंचाइज या सफरेज सब लोगों को दिया और विदाउट एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन दोनों ही सेक्शंस ऑफ द सोसाइटी, कोई भी जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन नहीं रहा। फ्रॉम फर्स्ट इलेक्शन टू टिल डेट वोटिंग राइट इज गिवन टू ऑल द पीपल्स ऑफ इंडिया ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ यूनिवर्सल अडल्ट फ्रेंचाइज। जिन कंट्रीज को आज की डेट में हम देखते हैं कि दे आर हैविंग द पार्टिसिपेंट पॉलिटिकल कल्चर एंड दे आर द डेवलप्ड आर द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड कंट्रीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, दोज कंट्रीज आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। आप यूनाइटेड स्टेट ऑफ अमेरिका को देखिए, इनिशियली वहां पे वीमेन्स को पॉलिटिकल राइट नहीं था, लेकिन वी आर द प्राउड इंडियन सिटीजन कि हमें शुरू से ही फर्स्ट इलेक्शन से हमें वोटिंग राइट मिला और आल द वीमेन्स आर लिविंग इक्वल एंड डिग्निफाइड लाइफ टू लीड अ हैप्पी एंड प्रॉस्पेरस कंट्री। थैंक्स अ लॉट।